by myself. God did. Speaking when nobody else would speak. Beginning at verse 13, now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" What are people saying about me? What do they think about me? What have you heard about me? Some of the disciples couldn't give an answer. They just gave some hearsay evidence. Like they didn't know for themselves who the Son of Man was. They had been walking with him every day along the dusty, dirty roads there in Jerusalem and surrounding areas. They had been seated at the table with him at the wedding in Cana of Galilee when he turned water into wine. But they couldn't say who he was. They had been with him when he fed the multitude on the hillside with five barley loaves and two fish, with 12 baskets left over, and they couldn't say who he was. Right. They had been with him when he walked on the water and calmed the raging sea and had Peter come to him. But they couldn't say who he was. And this is the answer that they gave. Some say John the Baptist. Now you and I know the story of John the Baptist when he pointed out the sins of folk in high places. I don't know why it's only the sins of the little people that get recorded on the 6 o'clock news. You don't ever see when the big folk do something, it gets covered up. You know, under the table stuff. It's just the sins of the little people, but when John the Baptist pointed out the sins of the king, John the Baptist was beheaded. So it couldn't have been John the Baptist. I mean, here he's got his head on his neck. So he couldn't have been John the Baptist. But others say that you are Elijah. You know Elijah, the Tishbite, who had all the trouble with the church. With the people. I almost said with the church folk. They weren't church folk. They weren't Christians. There's a difference. Elijah had all of this trouble. He battled with the priest there on Mount Carmel, and Elijah got tired and just went in a cave and just wanted to stay there, but God took a raven, old nasty bird, and catered Elijah's meal and told him, go on and eat now because you still got work to do. Some say Elijah. Some say that you are Jeremiah. You remember Jeremiah, don't you? That weeping prophet. The people would not do right and it just broke Jeremiah's heart, and Jeremiah got so frustrated and so uptight that he just stopped everything. But then Jeremiah said something like a fire shut up in his bones caused him to go back out there and do it again. Yeah, right. Jeremiah or
one of the prophets. Hosea, Ezekiel, which one of the prophets? You see, you and I come into God's house week after week, year after year. You and I do Bible study. We read the Bible at home. We have our daily devotions. And when somebody says, "Who is he?" we can't answer. Or we can tell you what he did for Mama. We can tell you what he did for Aunt Susan. We can tell you what he did for Uncle Joe. What has he done for you that you cannot say who he is? 11 disciples said, "You are John the Baptist," others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. But Jesus said, "I want you to speak for yourself. Who am I?" Well, some folk may say, "Lord, you are my healer." But there is a difference in healing. When you heal my wounded, broken heart, that's not the same as healing my broken leg. When you heal my mind of all of its confusion, that's not the same as healing a boo-boo on my elbow. When you fill me with your spirit instead of filling my stomach with some food, when you have opened my eyes to your goodness, your grace, and your mercy, that's different than going and getting an eye exam and new glasses. Speak for yourself. Who is he? And I bet if I went around this room, every one of you would say he was something different, because he's different in our lives each and every moment. There is a test that I gave, I think, to the administrative council. It's a spiritual gifts inventory, where you see what your spiritual gifts are. And every time I have taken that test, my gifts differ. Every day that God wakes us up, God blesses us in a new way. And I've got to speak for myself. Yes. I can't say how God has blessed you and claim it for me, because God hasn't blessed us in the same way. You see, last night somebody went to bed with a heavy heart. God woke them up this morning with a solution to the problem. Let me tell you what God did. I had a meeting in Bennett on Friday. I left my papers here at the office, and I refused to drive back over here to get them. I said, "I'll just get up early Friday morning, and I'll go pick up my papers, and I'll make the meeting at 8:30. My phone rings. It's Sam. Sam has left her keys here at the church. Dwayne could let her in the building, but he couldn't let her in the office. I said, "Sam, God done already worked this thing out." Got up, came over here, she got her key, I got my papers. Friends, God works out our problems even before we realize we have them. And when he works them out for us, we ought to be able to say, until we get it right. until we do his will. I'd like to think until we can speak for ourselves. Peter did it because Jesus asked him the question directly, but who do you say that I am? You notice the change in the question. Who do people say that the Son of Man is? And then he changes it to, who do you say that I am? Peter answered, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered him, blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades. And I'd like to put a little comma there. I didn't write this, but had I written, I would have put a comma there. Because in the King James Version, it said the gates of hell, comma. And all the little hellions around the gate, comma, will not prevail against it. But I didn't write this. My brothers and sisters, as we go through this week, let us speak for ourselves as to who God is in our lives and share with others what God has done for us. Amen. So be it. In the name of the Father.